Welcome to TwoCircles.net. We have with us Ms. Zaida Khan. She is the Congress MLA from Khan constituency. So ma'am, you are fighting a re-election campaign here. So what are the big issues you are facing right now?
There's not such a big issue. Everything is normal and it's a different election. Always the Khan election used to come on the basis of the caste, Hindu-Muslim.
Okay.
But this time it is not this election. This is for the person from outside and we are the local ones. That is the thing.
Oh, so it's outside versus inside a fight?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you're fighting it for the second time, but your family traditionally hold this. Your father was a renowned leader from this Mewat region.
Yeah, Mewat region, and he was the only person in India
to become to minister.
Become three states.
Yeah, three states. So obviously you have a legacy behind you, but still, this constituency is the Muslim majority constituency of Rajasthan and the most backward one. So what do you think, what had left behind? So what could have been done and it wasn't done at all?
In my tenure we got the two government colleges. We asked for the one, but CM Saab gave us two. And we got the residential schools also, one model school also. We have got minority hostels also for boys and girls, and the ITI also to minority.
In Khammam constituency?
Yeah, in Khammam constituency.
So there are colleges in this constituency?
Now they have started this year. Building will start and the land allotment is done. So it is going to start. Two we have got. So that is going to be, we were lacking in education. And if in any society that lacks in education, it lacks in everything.
Yes.
So now if the education is going to come in such a way that I am telling you, then definitely we will not be back.
So man, these things happen in elections. Promises are made just before the elections. But when it comes on the 5-year term, it hardly gets succeeded. So
I have done more than what I promised. I didn't promise for anything. I just said in my election that I'm going to follow my father's path and I will fulfill his dreams. This was my promise to the community and the whole area. And I have done more than that.
So what was your father's dream for this
constituency? It was this only, that education should be there for health sources, road should be good. This all was his. That was the thing.
So you are a woman MLA from this constituency, and this particularly Mewar Muslim community here is generally a patriarch in a nature. The Muslim women here are really subjected, downtrodden here. So what, as a woman MLA, you have taken steps for the empowerment?
This is what is, no? I'm going for education. Everything will be done after education. So I've got girls hall, hostel also separate, schools also separate, up to 12th, residential schools. That's going to help them.
So coming to the infrastructure development and the water projects, it also lagged behind in this race. So do you have any vision for your next term in this field?
I'm saying that we have done the development and will do the development. This is one thing, and we'll make a harmony in the society so that there's no issues.
You've spoken about harmony. 2 years back there was Gopalgarh incident which made the national headlines. So do you think it's an issue in this election?
No, it is not. I'm not against me. It's in my favor. Because it happened, and you know that 10 were murdered in that. But still it didn't went to any other village also. It was we confined it to that village only. So that was the good part.
So it was confined, but still police role was questionable in that way.
100% it is there, and I have always said that Mavs and Gujars are not for this, and police was behind them. That's what it happened.
So, madam, at that time, the Mew community was obviously agitated. They were at the receiving end of this police action. As a representative of your community, do you face any kind of resistance or resentment at that period?
Yeah, at that time the people were coming from outside and they fleered the society, and whatever people say, they go for that only. But now it is all, everything is normal. After 2-3 months only, everything was normal.
You also made an accuse in that case. So do you think it's a kind of political conspiracy against you? Or
100%. 100% it is that only.
Mm-hmm.
And I have always said that CBI is action. The investigation is not correct.
Mm-hmm.
The team should be changed.
Mm-hmm.
And they should, but the policemen and the administrative,
mm-hmm.
it was administrative lapse only.
Mm-hmm.
Because communal rights are when the police is not there and two, what do you say that? Tahir, what do you say that? Do paksh.
Two sides.
Mm-hmm.
They fight.
Mm-hmm.
That is called communal. But the police was present and mm-hmm. then all this happened.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely it was on there.
Mm-hmm. But in the center and in the state government, it's your party's government. Then how can CBI act in such a way?
No, it is acting. So what they say that it's a tota, that is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Because in our case it has happened. My name wasn't in FIR
mm-hmm.
and still they have made me accused
for it. Mm-hmm. So I toured some of the villages of your constituency and there was a thing that that some Muslims came at a period of incident and demanded that you should present a resignation as a matter of resentment.
I only said
mm-hmm.
in one panchayat,
mm-hmm.
I only said if the people want,
mm-hmm.
I am ready to resign from my post.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they are going to be there, then I will be MLA again.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, I am not going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So it was from my side proposal.
Mm-hmm.
But so they said, no, you continue.
Mm-hmm.
We have full faith in you.
Okay, so you withdrawn.
That's
that
why I didn't give any resignation.
Mm-hmm.
I just said, if
mm-hmm.
people want,
mm-hmm.
they can send my resignation at any time.
Mm-hmm. So, ma'am,
because my family, my father, my
mm-hmm.
grandfather, my brother also,
mm-hmm.
Chaudhry Zakir Hussain,
mm-hmm.
they have never thought for the chair.
Mm-hmm.
We always have served the people and we are ready to do
mm-hmm.
that.
So, madam, you have been a state minister, state minister of parliamentary affairs. So, you got that ministry after that incident. Do you think it is a kind of, it give a negative message in the community?
No, it is not, because I asked them before taking vote.
Okay.
They all were ready for it,
mm-hmm.
that's why I went.
They accepted it.
Huh.
Okay.
And it was that chance also that they were extending that time only.
Mm-hmm.
So, it was that.
Mm-hmm. So,
it was our right to become at the first time only.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, madam, as you have said, you are going to implement educational schemes here, education institutes. Why do you think till now this kind of things have lagged behind in this constituency?
Because Rajasthan is too vast, so money was also limited there, the
mm-hmm.
finance schemes and all.
Mm-hmm.
This time the government is giving and we are taking it. My father always planned it because in Haryana they have done that.
Mm-hmm.
My grandfather opened a school, my
mm-hmm.
father opened a private college over there.
Mm-hmm.
Now brother is working on that, we are trying to make it at university.
Mm-hmm.
So this was my dream also that I should carry on this thing in Rajasthan because it was lacking too much.
Mm-hmm. You are a Muslim MLA in this country, there are presently 12 Muslim MLAs in Rajasthan. You are also a state minister. But generally, coming to the larger Rajasthan politics, generally there is a kind of feeling in the Rajasthan Muslim population that they are not properly being represented in the assembly, that their voice is not being properly spoken in the assembly floor. How do you respond to it?
No, I to make my issues. I in the assembly,
mm-hmm.
I took the pension one,
mm-hmm.
and CM Sahab has given this pension to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
In my election when I was going everywhere, the people were saying that we should get a pension like it's given in Haryana.
Mm-hmm.
So I took the second time when I took it in assembly,
mm-hmm.
and it is done.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody appreciated that.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not going to speak, then how can the representation be done?
Mm-hmm. Did you spoke about Gopalgarh firing there?
That time, though, I was Parliament Secretary.
Okay.
And being a part of the government,
mm-hmm.
you can't speak. But
okay.
in the party and all, I have taken that issue.
Mm-hmm. So right now,
I took the two, three time representation also from my
mm-hmm.
here Kama, and we spoke to CM one to one.
Mm-hmm.
We want all that.
Mm-hmm. So coming to the political fight here, there is a line of Muslim contestants against you. So do you fear there is going to be a vote split in the community?
No. That's what I'm saying. It is the first time that everybody is single. Like the 12, there are 17 villages of Nogama.
Mm-hmm.
They gave me, Noganya they are called.
Mm-hmm.
They gave me yesterday that they are mm-hmm. with me.
Mm-hmm.
And like this everybody is coming close. Two sides of the villages they are coming close. And Dulot.
Mm-hmm.
They also gave me as today,
mm-hmm.
and usme wo bhi to the
Damrod.
In they all gave.
Mm-hmm. So against
that, they are with me wholly. Mm-hmm. There's no party now in the villages. Mm-hmm. Usually it is two times. Mm-hmm. Two parties are always there. Mm-hmm. But this time, this is the first time that everybody is there.
But there are strong contenders against you, like Lok Jan Shakti party leader.
What's his name?
Sher Mohammed something.
He's independent.
Kirori Lal Meena's
independent.
Kirori Lal Meena's party candidate, and there is one Muslim political party.
They don't have anything.
Okay, they are not contenders against you.
I don't think.
Last time you won with a margin of 7,000 votes.
Yeah.
So this time, are you planning to increase the margin?
These people have to decide.
Okay. All right. Thank you for speaking to us.
Thank you.